Not guilty. Mona Al-Tahawi is a journalist and an expert on Arab and Muslim issues, and she is just back from Cairo. And this is just the most bizarre spectacle. Did you ever think?
Obviously, every Egyptian had a dream that Mubarak would someday stand trial. So this is a truly historic day in terms of symbolism, in terms of an Arab country putting its own dictator on trial without an invasion, as in the case of Iraq when the U.S. invaded. But in terms of what's been happening in the courtroom itself, I know from most Egyptians that I'm following online that it's turned into quite a farce. But I think it's really important to focus on the historic symbolism of what's happening in Egypt today.
Okay, before we do the important stuff, I just want to talk a little bit more about Hosni Mubarak, because we've always seen pictures of him as a vital man, even though he's 83 years old. And here he is lying in a hospital bed on oxygen in a cage in a courtroom. Some people think he's pretending he'd be sick even now to garner public sympathy. What do you think?
Well, you know, it's interesting that during the 30 years of his rule, if anybody dared to question his health, he could face jail. And many journalists were actually sentenced to jail terms for questioning how well he was doing. And yet, since he was forced to step down because of the revolution, we've been getting almost weekly updates on how frail he is, on how he's in a coma, on how he's depressed. And I've got to wonder, you know, what kind of strings of public sympathy he's trying to pull today, because as you say, he's on a hospital bed with an oxygen tank, but his hair is black. He's 83 years old. He's obviously dying his hair. So how sick is this man?
Well, he does have the energy to do that. But I'm thinking there's something like really wrong with him. But they say high blood pressure and he's depressed and not eating well.
Yeah.
Well, there are a lot of people like that, like right now working here, and we're not in a hospital bed on oxygen.
Well, my sympathies are with civilians who are undergoing military trial in Egypt simply for being revolutionaries and for protesting against the military council that currently runs Egypt. We've replaced one Mubarak with a Supreme Council of Mubaraks. That's the military running the country, who are basically his buddies. So my sympathies firmly lie with the revolutionaries and the families of the martyrs. And Mubarak stands trial today for conspiring to kill those people in the revolution. So you know where my sympathies lie.
I do. Okay, so let's say that Mubarak is found guilty of all charges along with his two sons. Mm-hmm. Will this really make any difference? Since things in Egypt, as far as the pro-democracy protesters are concerned, are pretty much the same.
Well, that's the challenge in Egypt, that things are the same regime-wise, because Mubarak's friends are the ones who are running the country right now. But why this trial matters is because Egyptians wanted to see a concrete result, at least one concrete result from the revolution. And putting on trial the dictator of 30 years, who many people believe is responsible for the deaths of at least 1,000 people during the revolution, is really symbolic, not just for Egypt, but for the other countries around Egypt. Because what's happening today is every dictator in the region is watching this in total fear, thinking that he could be next. And all the citizens in the region, the ordinary people in the Arab or the Middle East and North Africa, are thinking, wow, we wish we could put our tyrants on trial. And just think of Assad in Syria right now, who is massacring his citizens in Hama and other parts of Syria, and probably using this trial as a distraction. So I think this is an important boost of inspiration for revolutions across the region.
Yeah, it's interesting. It's just interesting as an aside that Israel is carrying this trial live.
Well, you know, Israel, I mean, most Egyptians have complete hate for Israel because they believe, first of all, because of the occupation, and second of all, because the Israeli government made it very clear that they supported our dictator. Mm-hmm. Anyone who supported our dictator, I mean, there were five U.S. presidents who supported our dictator, and you've got to wonder, those of them who are still alive, what are they thinking now that the man who they kept calling a reformer and a stable president, he's lying in a cage pretending to be sick? I mean, it's pathetic. So, you know, this is a message to everybody who supports dictators and to dictators themselves, that you will be held accountable.
Thank you so much for joining us this morning. Fascinating conversation. I wish we could go on.
Thanks for having me.
Christine.
All right, gridlock on the streets.